वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द चिल्ड्रन ऑफ क्लास 10th डी. काइंडली बेटा रिवीजन स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम टुडे ऑनवर्ड्स एंड अच्छा हाँ आई विल बी स्पीकिंग बेटा आई विल टेल यू व्हाट इज रिटन ठीक है व्हाट एवर डाउट यू हैव. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द रिवीजन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1 अ लेटर टू गॉड. यू नो सो मेनी डेज आई हैव बीन देयर एंड यू हैव इवन अपीयर्ड फॉर द टेस्ट एंड वी ऑल नो हाउ यू पीपल आर डूइंग. So rather than depending upon the things, your objective type paper is going to confuse you a lot. And what will help you in that? Thorough reading. This time you have to read the chapter not once but twice or thrice. Fine? And you are getting golden opportunity that we are going to revise thoroughly each and every point once again. One lecture, one chapter, or even two lectures. If it goes, I'll continue, no problem. We have enough time. But you should be sitting as if don't give your brain to others. Firstly, others will, misbehave with you. They will just indulge you in some other talks. At that moment, you get attracted, okay, I should also talk and I should listen to my friend. But this is the loss of yours at the end of the day. Your exams will be offline. Make sure. So don't say that, think that we are going to have online exam and what will do whatever we want to do. Clear? So that is the thing. You are going to appear for offline exams. Better be prepared. First of all, correctors. So this is the way. Revision notebook ek laga lo. Sare subjects ki chahe or subject wise, that is up to you. Chapter number 1, A Letter to God. Characters are Lenko. He's the protagonist. And he's a farmer who's involved into, every year he is just doing farming and all, being a farmer. And he waits for natural thing, that is rain, shower, so that his production is beautifully, received and he can get and sell it out in the market and receive the gains accordingly. Fine. So here what happens, he is the protagonist. Then we have postmaster, we have post office employees, and we have postman also. Clear? So these are the basic characters. There are some family members of Lenko also, but they have no any particular role. So that's why I have missed it. These characters are in action into the chapter. So that's why preferably I have written this. What is the theme of the story? That is unquestionable faith in Almighty. There are two types of faith. Sometimes, when we are getting everything good, we are very thankful ki, wow, God is very, kind to me, giving me all the basic amenities of life. Second kind of faith is which cannot be shaken by anyone. Even if you are in troubles, even if you are in bad situations of life or bad days, jisko rainy days keh dete hain, fine? Even at that time, you have unquestionable faith in Almighty, in God. So that sort of innocence is there. That sort of faith is there in Lenko, that he just loves God to that extent that nobody can break or shake his faith. Clear? Then background is set in, this chapter is set in one of the countries of Latin America. Clear? So this is, and currency, we'll be talking about pesos. Let me start with this now. Is it clear? Characters are clear. Theme is clear to all of you. And also the background is clear to all of you. Meri awaaz piche tak aa rahi hai aapko beta? So while introducing, actually a letter to God is a real letter which Lenko will be writing. So in the beginning, what happens? In the beginning, he firstly, basic thing, aap ek points bana ke likhte jao. The only house in the entire valley. Fine? Points bana lo so that it will be very helpful, during the exams. The only house in the entire valley on the crest of a low hill. On the crest, C-R-E-S-T, on the crest of a low hill. Fine. So now try to understand this point. Where the house is situated? his house is situated on the crest of the low hill, from where he can get the view of river, of ripe corn fields, which he himself is growing. Fine. So he is into the crops of corn, C-O-R-N. You must know this. Objective question can be anything, beta. Even if one talk to the person, you're missing one number in that way. So crest of a low hill, and from this height, one could see the river, fields of corns, fine. Flowers over there means a good harvest was visible from his own house only. So the only thing he required, yes, beta. In that way only, I'm telling you. So that's why they are saying that we got a question of where does Lenko live, and they got confused because so aise questions aane, be prepared. That was just you can say there you need to apply your brains only. Fine. I don't remember all the, I'll go through that question firstly because I don't remember the all the options, and then. So I'll find out and let you know about that. Fine. We will do MCQs also. Don't worry. After finishing this. No, all is not an answer here. No. So firstly, let's continue with the chapter. Then we will move on to MCQs. So the only thing now needed was a downpour of rain. Clear? So everything is good. He's having a house and to live in, fine. He has put in efforts also. He has grown the crop of corn, good crop harvested this time, but he was waiting for rain. Clear? This is the beginning of the chapter. Clear? What do you mean by downpour? Rather than writing heavy rain, you will be using the word downpour. D-O-W-N-P-O-U-R. Fine. This is the way a 10th class student should write. Fine. Then after that, what happens? So he wanted water, fine. The whole family was waiting. The older boys were working in the field while the smaller ones were playing near the house when rain started. Fine, his wife was also there. Big drops of rain started falling. And Lenko was so happy to see that finally his dream is coming true when he saw the big droplets of water. And then suddenly what happened? Fresh air was there, sweet atmosphere, you know. Suddenly what happened? Those big drops, they were changed into hailstorms, which is not at all required. Fine, excess of anything is bad here. Clear? So he was expecting for downpour, but actually it converted into hailstorm. So it was just like these are not raindrops falling from the sky. Firstly, when he saw the raindrops, what he said, these are the new coins for me. Why he says so? Because after selling the crop, definitely he's going to earn the money. So he was happy. So when everything changed and, you know, at that time changed into, and you could see the expression on his face. It was very sad and grave. Grave means very serious. Fine. When large hailstones began to fall. So these truly did resemble like new silver coins are falling from the sky. So boys were also, you know, they were jumping and they started collecting the pearls. These are the pearls only. Raindrops jo thi, or hailstorms jo the, they started collecting, they started merrymaking and all. Fine. So after that, what happened? But when it did not stop, you know, it was just continuing in the further period also, and he grew sad at that moment. He's saying that now it is getting over the board. Fine, this is not required. So he wanted to get it over quickly now. See, he was waiting for the rain, but when hailstorm started, and now he wanted it to be stopped immediately. Fine. Yes, Daksh, sit properly. The hailstones covered the entire valley. What was covered? House, garden, hillside, cornfield, everything started looking white. Everything was covered in hailstones. सो दैट एज इफ इट वॉज कवर्ड विद सॉल्ट, जैसे सॉल्ट होता है ना व्हाइट कलर का, तो यू कुड फील दैट सॉल्ट इज देयर स्कैटर्ड ऑल ओवर. क्लियर? सो सिमिली इज यूज्ड हियर, द सॉल्ट लाइक सॉल्ट और एज सॉल्ट. फाइन. एंड नॉट अ सिंगल लीफ वॉज लेफ्ट ऑन द ट्रीज, नॉट अ सिंगल लीफ. द कॉर्न वॉज टोटली डिस्ट्रॉयड. सो विच क्रॉप, यस Rian, tell me which crop was grown by Lenko. Nobody will speak. See how attentive you are sitting. Daksh, see the language they are using here. The last boy. This is what projects your, you know, behavior. This is not your Hindi Punjabi class going on. How attentive you are. Yes, Divyansh. Which crop was grown by Lenko? I need to, you know, I want to clap or slow clap for you all. Girls, no, I know that. Ab to sun liya aapne corn. Even if I will say, na, it is wheat or rice, you will say, yes, ma'am. That shows your attentiveness. They have given the answer, corn. Or even if after this also you do not listen. Which crop? Corn, C-O-R-N. Clear, children sitting at home? Is it clear to all of you which crop was grown by Lenko? Fine. So, now next is, Lenko became stressed. He became disappointed. Abhi bhi sun lo. He became disheartened, dejected. Many words are there to express the emotions. Dejected, disheartened. Jiske spelling achche se aate hain, jo yaad aayega, you can write that. Clear? And sometimes synonyms are asked, antonyms are asked. If you know the meanings of more words, that will be easier for you. So what happened? He conveyed his dismay and sorrow to his sons also. Fine? That this time the storm is, this has destroyed my crop. So he started discussing this with his family. Dismay is also in the same way when you are in the grief, the feeling of, yes, feeling of dismay is that only when you feel very bad. So all their hard work had gone in vain. It was wasted. Wasted means vain. V-A-I-N. Clear? And at the end of the day, Tanya, you will be writing some words which you are noting down on the board. Clear? The new words which we have learned today only. Then in the hearts of heart, all lived that solitary house in the middle of the valley. There was a single hope left now. The only house in the entire valley was of Lenko. And he was just having one thing with him now, that was hope. Fine? He was having the hope to get the help from the Almighty, that is God. Yes, beta. Beta, word meanings nahi aayenge. This is not a question even. You can get any synonym, antonym, meaning. So you should improve your vocabulary because see, how only MCQs, 40-50 MCQs will be on your, this thing only. Words will be there. Fine? Synonyms, antonyms and word meanings you have to learn. Clear? That's what I'm saying, improve your vocabulary. So solitary means lonely. Clear? Solitary word I'm using, it means lonely, all alone. Clear? Existing alone, you can say. So everything had gone wrong. You know, इसको कैसे कहते हैं? When everything had gone southwards. What does it mean? Southwards means wrong. Fine, in English, it is a meaning. Everything has gone southwards in my life. It means everything has gone wrong. It is a way of saying. So when everything had gone wrong, family still had the hope in heart of hearts that help from God. Lenko was an ox of a man. Very important this is. An ox of a man means very hard working. An ox of a man means he was very hard working. Just like an animal, he used to work in the fields. He never, you know, used to take breaks, continuously working without any, you know, stoppage and all. So the following Sunday, he decided to ride. After that incident, whichever Sunday came, the following Sunday, fine. So on that particular Sunday, he decided to write a letter. And to whom he decided to write a letter? To God. And then after that, Is it clear? Ox of a man means hardworking. Fine. Daybreak. Daybreak means the time in the morning when first time the light appears. जब सन की फर्स्ट लाइट आती है मॉर्निंग में दैट इज नोन एज डे ब्रेक. क्लियर? सी वी आर इंप्रूविंग अवर वोकैबुलरी ऑल टुगेदर. यस बेटा, आर यू नोटिंग डाउन? चिल्ड्रन सिटिंग एट होम, आई विल बी सीइंग योर नोटबुक्स. ओके, यू विल स्विच ऑन द कैमरा एंड शो मी द नोटबुक्स वेदर यू आर नोटिंग डाउन ऑर नॉट. देन बेटा वी हैव इन हिज लेटर. नाउ कॉन्टेंट ऑफ द लेटर, व्हाट ही रोट, लेट्स रिवाइज दैट. When I'm revising, I'm making every point clear. When I will ask you tomorrow, if even well goes, na tomorrow it will be an oral test for you all. It will be a MCQ kind of or one word answers. So the one who won't be able to answer can leave the class immediately. Or I'll be removing the online students then. This is the way only to find. Fine, because you people are taking everything casually. Board ki class hai. We were so serious when we were in 10th. And this time you people are thinking online and all. And suddenly I'm telling you that offline exams will be there. This is very much sure. And in September, you are having your exams. Clear? Yes, offline, definitely offline. So in this letter of to God, he communicated, firstly, beta, he communicated his poverty-stricken situation. In his letter to God, what he did? He communicated his poverty-stricken situation. And mentioned that. What did he mention? Yes, last boy. Don't disturb others. After communicating his poverty-stricken situation, he demanded 100 pesos. Yes, what amount, last boy, I spoke? Tell me the amount which I just finished only. What's his name? Karthik. 100 pesos. Now, after listening, you're telling. Please have your own brains with yourself only. Keep it with you. Don't give it to others. Better. So after conveying his poverty-stricken situation, he mentioned that he needed 100 pesos to regenerate the crops. Fine? He's not saying that with 100 pesos he's going to buy and go for shopping. He's saying with 100 pesos, he would be regenerating the crops. Along with surviving also. After this, he needs some money for survival also. For regeneration of crops as well as surviving until their harvest is ready, until their next harvest is ready, he needs some money for their survival of the family. Clear? And after that, he wrote what he wrote on the envelope. He wrote to God. He did not have any address of the God. He just wrote to God on the envelope. And even he put a stamp on this, you know. And after writing to God at the post office, he placed a stamp on the letter. After stamping, he put it in the mailbox. Clear? After that, beta, one of the employers who was a postman and also helped at the post office other works, and, you know, he started laughing after seeing this. So I'm talking about postman. So when he saw this, postman also used to do other works in the post office rather than receiving and giving letters. He started having a hearty laugh. He started laughing in a very bossy way. This is what he's seeing in front of his eyes. A man is writing a letter to God. Fine. So never in his career, a postman had seen this address. What was the reason of his laugh? Because a postman had never ever eyewitnessed somebody is writing a letter to God. So that's why he started laughing. Clear? So the postmaster, now write a brief character sketch. Postmaster, a fat, amiable fellow. Postmaster is fat, amiable. Amiable means loving. Fine, amiable fellow. And, you know, he also broke out laughing very easily. Some people, you know, they laugh without any reason also. Sometimes they can laugh at any situation. So he was that kind of jolly kind of person. So he broke out laughing, but also immediately he turned serious. It was not that he will keep on joking about others. Firstly, he laughed, but immediately he realized that no, I should not laugh. So he became very serious. Clear? And tapping the letter on his desk, he commented after receiving the letter what he did. He says, what a faith. I wish I had the faith of the man who wrote this letter. He was so impressed. You can get this also. A dialogue is written. Who spoke this dialogue? I'm just giving you one example that you can get this, that who spoke this dialogue. Or niche likha hoga post office employee, postmaster, postman, lenko, in that way. And sometimes dialogue will be like that, that jisne chapter nahi padha usko kuch samajh mein nahi aaya. That's why thorough reading is required. So he starting up a correspondence with God. Clear? So he's saying that correspondence means, aapne kabhi padha hoga address for correspondence. It does not mean that sometimes you are living at a, you are, kuch bachche hote ho, kisi aur city mein rehte hain, but they are studying in some other place. So their letter will be exchanged at which address? That is your address of correspondence. Clear? Where you will be receiving and sending letters from. So that becomes your address of correspondence. So now with whom the correspondence is initiated? With God he has initiated, Lenko. And by seeing this faith, that postmaster was quite impressed. Firstly, he laughed and then he was impressed that he wished that even if he could have such faith. Clear? After that, he showed this letter. Postman showed this letter to the postmaster. He thought that I should discuss this thing with postmaster. Clear? Hanji, postman was a fat and amiable fellow who broke into laughing easily, but he was very responsible also. He immediately realized his mistake. Bas ye itna sa character sketch tha. Postman bola maine. I'm saying postmaster. Fine, fine. Okay, even sometimes I get confused. Hanji, it is human nature. So then, with good intentions, postmaster read the letter. They never, you know, this is bad thing to read anyone's letter. But he knew that this letter is addressed to God and there is no address where they will be sending this letter. And by seeing the faith of this innocent man, they decided, let's read this. Fine. So with good intentions, the postmaster read the letter and thought ki I should reply to it. And not only reply, he decided to help him also. So he asked all of his employees and postman, and he himself also gave part of his salary. And they decided to help this farmer. Fine. And it was impossible for him to, you know, collect 100 pesos. But he was able to send a little more than half. That is near about 70 pesos. So he could collect 70 pesos and... Yes, beta. This is to send the child at the reception. Paramveer, you can leave, beta. Fine, then... Despite his best efforts, he could collect 70 pesos. Yes, beta, yes. The following Sunday, next Sunday now again, and Lenko was, you know, he came earlier at the post office, a bit earlier, and to ask whether there is reply from God or not. And postman himself, you know, handed over, not postmaster again, I'm saying. Immediately, beta, you can go. Postman handed the letter to Lenko that yes, there is reply from God. Fine. Immediately, Lenko just, you know, was so excited that he went up to the window to ask for paper and ink. After... Beta, this is a fictional chapter, Chahat. Fictional. There is a difference between fake and fiction, beta. ऐसे तो कोई चैप्टर बनेगा ही नहीं फिर आपकी बुक का, ऐसे ही बस ओरिजिनल स्टोरीज ढूंढते रहो. व्हाई डू यू गो टू वॉच मूवीज वेयर यू नो ऋतिक रोशन इज जंपिंग फ्रॉम द बिल्डिंग and you're just, you know, clapping, wow, and people like you only are there. So this is fiction. Anything is possible. See? Okay. We'll continue tomorrow.